Welcome to our new series of the online classes. This is my first interaction to you. Children, today I am going to discuss first chapter from class 10th, that is real numbers of mathematics class 10th. Children, in the chapter of real numbers, we have to learn about the real numbers. So let us have some introduction about the number family. Children, number family consists two types of numbers, mainly two types of numbers, that is real number and imaginary number. Imaginary number is not in the syllabus of your class 10th. We have to read it in class 11th. So let's left it. Now come to the real number. Real number consists a group of all natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers and irrational numbers. And all these numbers, about these all numbers you have. So now we have to discuss the topics of the chapter real numbers. This chapter mainly consists three topics. Number one, Euclid's division lemma. Number two, fundamental theorem of arithmetic, and number three, rational and irrational numbers with their decimal expansion. Mainly the topics which we have to discuss in this chapter is Euclid's division lemma, fundamental theorem of arithmetic, and third one is rational and irrational numbers with their decimal expansion. Now come to the first topic, Euclid's division lemma. For now, in as you know that Euclid was a great mathematician, and there is a new word in it, which is lemma. What is lemma? Lemma is a well or proven statement which needs to prove another statement. And Euclid's division lemma states that for any two positive integers, say a and b, there exist two unique integer, unique whole numbers q and r, such that a equals to bq plus r, where r lies between 0 and b. R is greater than equal to 0 but a smaller than b. And one more thing you have to remember in this Euclid's division lemma is that a must be greater than b. Now this is make it this thing little more easier. Children, it is not a new thing, it is the division algorithm only. As you know from the division algorithm, dividend equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Now, what is the purpose of this Euclid's division lemma? The main purpose of this Euclid's division lemma to find the HCF. This method is very convenient and very less time taking in finding the HCF of larger numbers. This is very much helpful. You have already know many methods of finding HCF, such like prime factorization method, long division method. But this method actually makes the things very easier while we deal with the larger numbers. Now take an example to make it more clear. We have taken an example to find the HCF of 960 and 432. From Euclid's division lemma, you place the larger number among these two, that is 960, at the place of A, and the smaller number, that is 432, at the place of B. So 960 can be expressed like 432 into 2 plus 96. And similarly in second stage, B becomes A. So 432 can be written like 96 into 4 plus 48. And in last third stage, 96 can be written like 48 into 2 plus 0. When your remainder comes 0, then you stop the process, and the last value of the B, that is 48, is your required HCF. So this is the main purpose of finding the HCF by this Euclid's division lemma. And in this